Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Spill the Tea.
I'm your host, Kiera Benson.
And I'm your co-host, Nicole Catch.
And today we are going to be spilling the tea on some makeup mishaps and some other crazy stories that involve beauty treatment. Did you know, Nicole, that June 4th, which is actually today, is National Nail Polish Day?
Interesting. I didn't.
Yeah. So it's kind of ironic because with everything being closed, people can't get their nails done, but you certainly can do it at home. But before we get into that kind of discussion and some other beauty stories, we'd like to remind you guys to go on Facebook and look up Radio Felician. And you can also call us at 201-340-4374. I'm going to repeat that number one more time, 201-340-4374. And also make sure to go on our Instagram and follow Felician Spill the Tea 123. So with that said, Nicole, I'm going to let you take it away.
Awesome. Yeah, so I've actually been getting my nails done from the salon since I was in about 7th, 8th grade. The first time actually might have been for social when I was in 8th grade. So now, you know, with everything going on, everybody's kind of been doing their own thing at home, which I've been painting my nails at home, and which is okay, you know, save some money. But have you ever gone to a nail salon and had your nails done and not liked it?
Yes. I feel like I've had that happen pretty frequently.
Right.
It's because, like, when I was younger, I used to go a lot. Like, my grandmother would just bring me with her so I could get my, like, you know, manicure or whatever. And I feel like because I was younger, they used to ask me, oh, do you, like, want us to do a design? And I would say yes. And, like, sometimes it wouldn't turn out, like, how I thought it would. And I'd just be like, oh.
I know. It's like, what do you do? Like, I've never been like, oh, I don't like it, you know, because I feel like all their hard work, like they probably think they've done such a good job. And I'm like, oh, okay, now I have to wait like 2 weeks like this.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like once it's on for a few days, I feel like you might get used to it a little bit and kind of just, you know, warm up to it.
Right, right. No, 100%.
I feel like every time I go to the nail salon, I try and like get a different color, you know, like than the last few times, because I want to switch it up a little bit, especially since it lasts for so long.
Right, right. And you don't want to have like the same thing. I feel like that's what's cool about like the different times of year, you know, like, and you can kind of match it to the holiday, or like, you know, if it's springtime, you might want a pink, and like that. I feel like those things are really cool, how you can change it up like that.
Yeah, for sure. And I don't know about you, but the nail salon near me, what they do is they have like, you know, all the colors and stuff, but they actually have a section called the weekly nail polish section. And it's like they switch out the colors there every week. So it's something different every time you go in. So they get like all these different shades depending on like the season and, you know, all that kind of stuff. And it's really cool because then, you know, like you have different options and not just the same ones every time you go.
Right. And I feel like a lot of people like to do what's common, you know, and what's really, like you said, a popular color of that week or of the month. So that's pretty cool that they do that. I wish more salons had, you know, had done that before.
Yeah, for sure. It's pretty cool. So let's get into spilling the tea on some crazy stories that have happened. I guess I'll go first. We're going to kind of switch a little bit to hair salon. So there was this one time, for my sweet 16, obviously I was going to get my hair done because it's a special day. You only turn 16 once. And I know a lot of people, you know, do something big for their sweet 16. So I got like my dress ahead of time and I was like all ready. And my mom was like, you know, like, let's get your hair done at the salon down the street from us instead of going a couple towns over to the place we usually go, because she had like a coupon or something. But it was like she chose like the wrong day to do that because it was my sweet 16. It was really important and we shouldn't have gone to a hair salon that, you know, we've never gone to before. Because what happened was, is, you know, the lady asked me like, you know, what are you looking to do? And I had a couple of screenshots of hairstyles I saw online, but the problem was, is like my hair is so thin that she couldn't do the type of braids that I wanted and stuff. So she tried like over and over again, and I told her like, if it's not coming out like how it looks in the photo, like just don't do it, because I didn't want it to look bad, you know what I mean?
Right.
But she didn't listen, and she just like continued to do it anyways, and it just looked like bad, like I didn't like it, and she thought it was like amazing. She's like, your hair looks so great and blah blah blah, and my mom and I just kind of looked at each other and we were like, can you somehow fix it a little bit, because like it was just, I don't know, it was just weird the way it looked. And then she was like,
that's terrible.
Yeah, and she was just kind of like, well, you're wearing a tiara, right? And my mom like gave it to her, and she was like, well, when I put the tiara in, it'll look better. And she put the tiara in, and it just looked so bad. Like, I was just like, so like, oh my god, my sweet 16 is like in an hour, like fix this. Like, you know, like. And she couldn't get the crown out of my head, like the way she wedged it in, it got stuck like in the, like in the braids, and it was just a complete disaster. And she just was like, we'll just leave it, we'll give it you a discount. And it was so bad, like, so, but like luckily my aunt owns her own hair salon, and so does my cousin, so they tried to fix it up a little bit like when they got there, but otherwise it kind of just stayed that way. But
oh my god, I would have cried. I've actually had a similar situation. I didn't go to a place that I didn't know, but somebody had did my hair, and I feel like it was like that for a prom for me actually, and it wasn't my favorite. A lot, everybody told me that it looked nice, but I feel like my vision of it was just different, you know. And I feel like when you have big events like that, your expectation is much higher than regular, because you want it to like look the best.
Yeah, for sure. No, it's, I just remember I was so upset, because like when I saw these pictures online of like these girls with these hairstyles, I was like, I'm gonna look so beautiful, and then this lady just completely like trashed it, you know. But from like that, you know, basically the moral of the story is make sure you go to a hair salon you can trust. So from that day forward, I've been going to the one hair salon that I usually always go to, and they were the ones who have done all my varsity dinner hairstyles and my prom like hairstyles and stuff like that, and it came out beautiful for, you know, everything else of course, except for my sweet 16.
Right, it's good when you get, when you go to like the same person, and you know, they know like what you like and what you're into, and this way you can, they can expect like what you want, so that's cool. I've been doing the same thing actually.
Yeah, it was actually funny, because for my senior prom, I had two proms my senior year. I had my boyfriend at the time, his prom, his junior prom, and then I had my senior prom. So I went to the hair salon a few before the first prom, and they actually did like a test run, and they did a bunch of different hairstyles for like one price, just to see what I liked and what I didn't like, so that way the day of prom didn't come and I was like, oh my god, I hate this, you know. So I kind of like how they took the time to do that. And it was pretty cheap actually for them to just fool around with my hair and try different stuff. So it was, you know, it was really good. And, you know, I ended up picking which hairstyles I wanted for each prom. And it was cool because, you know, I also showed them my dress, and they were like, well, if you have a dress of this kind of backing, you want this kind of hairstyle. And it was just, it was really great.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's why I try to, when I have like a big event or something, I kind of try to just do, get something done that they can't really like mess up, you know. Like, I don't like anything too like extravagant, just like a little bit of curls and something that looks different, you know, than your normal.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's what I usually do. I think my senior prom was the only one that I actually did something I usually don't do, and it was like this kind of like up hairstyle where they kind of curled it but had it in a bun, and it was just, it was really pretty the way they did it. I don't know how to explain it.
Right.
Used a lot of bobby pins, and when I came home they were just like everywhere. Like
I was just gonna tell you that story about prom actually, how when I had like my hair and makeup done. So, you know, like you obviously go over the top for prom, you're not gonna wear your everyday makeup, and you know, so I had like lashes put on, and that was like the first time ever that I had like fake lashes put on. And the same thing with the, they had like in my hair some, a lot of like bobby pins and I guess like some extensions, and I didn't know about that. So when I had like gotten home that night, like, you know, you're already tired from the whole night, yeah, of like pictures, dancing, you know. And I got home and I was like, oh my god, like I could not take my lashes off. They were like super glued on, and that was taking like so long. And then like I didn't even notice, like I was it had to be like 100 bobby pins in my hair.
Oh, it's ridiculous when they do prom hairstyles, like so, right? Many bobby
pins. I was like, mm-hmm, never again.
Mm-mm, no. Yeah, it was so bad. I remember, yeah, no, but it's funny you said that, like the night I came home from every prom, I was exhausted. And it was like to have to pull all these bobby pins out of my hair, I was like, this is ridiculous. Like, you know, I just want to like throw on some pajamas and jump in bed, you know?
Right. I don't even think I had gotten them all out that night. Like the next morning I woke up and I was still taking them out. They were so hidden in my hair.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it's interesting how they do all those things. But it is pretty. Like, I feel like prom is a time where you can really go over the top, you know?
Yeah, for sure. Speaking of going over the top, there was one time for one of my varsity dinners for golf where my grandmother, usually she like will let me go get my hair done at the hair salon I always go to, but this one time they didn't have any appointments available, and she was like, you know what, like I got these new like brushes and this new blow dryer, and I'm gonna like blow dry out your hair and it's gonna look so pretty and I'm gonna like curl it and whatever. But she didn't want to use an actual curling iron. She wanted to curl it like where you take that, you know, that weird looking brush where it has the bristles on all sides and it's like circular, like,
yep.
Like she wanted to curl it that way, like the natural way when you blow dry it. So I was like, okay, cool. So like I was in her kitchen sitting on a like on a chair and she was doing it, and my little cousin was in front of me, and he like, we were just talking and playing with this slime stuff that he got, and all of a sudden I feel her like yanking on my head, and I'm like, ow, that hurts. And she's like, we have a problem. And then just like my cousin just like looks, and he was like, oh, bye, you're on your own. And just like left.
It got stuck.
It got stuck. Mm-hmm. And like the bristles, oh my God, it got stuck in my hair, and she didn't know what to do. Cause like my varsity dinner was like in an hour, and it's like, I want to say like a 25 minute drive to get to the place. So she started panicking. She's like, oh my God, like what do I do? So she was literally trying to yank it out. So what she did was she got pliers and individually took every single bristle out of the hairbrush, like ruining the hairbrush, and tried to like fix my hair like a little bit, because it was almost done when it got stuck. So she just kind of tried to fix it a little bit, and then like, oh my God, I just remember one, my hair looked really bad because she started excessively using hairspray because she thought that would help and it didn't.
Right.
And then like the entire night I was like pulling like bristles out of my hair like at the dinner. I'm just like,
oh my god. I know, that's why I refuse to buy a brush like that, because I could never do it myself.
Mm-mm, I'm afraid of those brushes now after that. That was so painful. Like,
right. Yeah, no, it's terrible. I don't know how. And you see in the hair salon, like they flip your hair around and twirl it and this and that and like nothing. I'm like, forget it. I would have no hair after that.
No, I can't. But honestly, like, moral of the story, just, I'm not saying to get it professionally done, but, like, get it done by someone who knows what they're doing. Like, right. Sorry, Grandma, love you, but, like, like, there was one time on Valentine's Day, like, back in high school, I think it was my senior year, actually, I wanted to just make my hair look pretty, because I was wearing, like, a cute, like, red dress to school, because I don't know, like, I love, like, holidays like that, like, I always go all out, and so I remember I was curling my hair and I was on the phone with my boyfriend at the time and I wasn't paying attention, and I put the curling iron like against my forehead and I didn't feel it at first. Like, don't ask me how I didn't feel like the heat just like burning my skin, but I didn't. And I remember it left this like giant mark on my forehead because like the curling iron just like burnt my like forehead. I was like,
oh my God.
So yeah, moral of the story, if you don't know what you're doing, don't try it. Like, I can't, honestly. But
yeah, you have to be careful. Those like heating tools are, forget it. They can really burn you bad.
Yeah, no, you have to be really careful, like honestly. But speaking of being really careful, let's kind of move on to makeup. I have a couple of good stories, but I don't know, do you have a story to share about makeup, or it was just the prom one?
Yeah, I have some tips to share, so I can do one or two of them now. My first one is, for those of you who shop in Sephora, you can go there, and if you see a, like, product that you might want to buy, like a concealer or a foundation, they will actually pour it in a little container for free, and you'll be able to take that home with you and try it. Because I know some of the, you know, like foundations can be very expensive. You know, they can go from $30 to probably $60 or $70. And you can do that. You could take it home, and it usually, they usually give you a supply for at least 2 to 3 days. So, you know, before you go and spend that much money, if you don't like it, you know, you can just go and ask for another one, and you know, don't buy it until you found the foundation that you actually like.
Yeah, no, that's great. Honestly, it's always great to be able to test out, you know, a product ahead of time, because you never know. Like, I hate when I buy something and then it's not what I was looking for. You know what I mean? That's why I really like Sephora.
Really, yeah, and especially like when they're so expensive, you know, you want to make sure that, you know, what you're purchasing is actually good, or even if it's worth it. Because a lot of the times, yeah, like, you can find, like, you know, dupes to a, you know, foundation or something, and you can get, like, you know, e.l.f. or Clinique that are not so expensive, and, you know, use that instead.
I was just about to say that on our radio show Instagram, Felician Spill the Tea 123. Make sure to go follow. We took a poll about what makeup brands everyone thought was the best, and e.l.f. seemed to be one of the number one type of makeup that people liked, you know?
Yeah, it is. I had actually just bought the other day an e.l.f. lip gloss, and I love it. It was only $5. And, you know, most of the other brands that are expensive, they start from like $20 and up. And it works.
Yeah,
the same. I really.
Yeah, no, it's great. Honestly, like that's what I usually get. I usually get e.l.f. On the rare occasion, I'll buy something a little more expensive if like I need it for some reason. But for me, sometimes I'll wear makeup like casually, but I more use it for like YouTube videos and like cosplaying and like that kind of stuff. So like I more buy like exotic type of makeup, but e.l.f. has that kind of stuff. So, and it's cheap too. And if I'm using it one time, then I want to buy it cheap, you know?
Right. You don't want to buy something expensive. Like, because I know sometimes if you're doing, like you said, something exotic, maybe you're using like a blue or a green, you're not going to use that in an everyday look, you know?
Yeah. But don't ever go too cheap, because one time I was doing a favor for my sibling's school, and they were doing a fundraiser, and they were doing this like family fun day, and it was like under the sea theme, and they wanted to have Ariel and Ursula there to like greet the kids, and you could take a photo for like $1 with them or whatever, and they would print it out for you like on the spot. And so my friend just so happens to kind of like, she has like Ariel's type of hair. So I asked her, she'd be Ariel and I could be Ursula. And so I had to go find like purple, like eyeshadow type stuff to do my face and like, and everything. But I literally made the worst mistake of my life. And I went to the dollar store and I got purple eyeshadow from there, because CVS didn't have a purple that I was looking for. So I was like, it should be fine. And it wasn't fine. Like my face completely broke out. Like after, like I used it, like when I got home and took it all off, like my face was just like, no, no, no. Like you don't ever use this again.
Right.
So my suggestion is don't ever go too cheap, you know, like e.l.f. is just that right, like e.l.f. works, like, you know what I'm saying? Like my face does not break out from that kind of stuff. But if you're getting dollar store type brands, like no, like,
yeah, you can't do that.
No, like honestly, like that's for like, I don't even know what that's for. I feel like they just have that in the store for like kids like messing around with their like dolls and stuff, honestly, you know?
Yeah, and a lot of the times like those stuff will make you break out, you know?
Mm-hmm. And it was just crazy. Like, I remember I had to, like, use so many other products to get my face back to normal, you know?
Yeah, you definitely have to be careful. And like I said, you know, if you're shopping in, like, Ulta or Sephora, they will definitely work with you and, you know, see which product is good for your face. Like, if you have oily skin or dry skin, you know, or just regular normal skin. And there's, you know, different products for each type of skin that you have. So, you know, definitely take advantage of those.
Yeah, for sure. I actually recently, before everything broke out, Corona, like a few months before that, I actually had someone come from Mary Kate, you know, the other makeup company. And she brought a whole bunch of products, and she like taught us how to apply it. Like me and my mom and my friend and her mom like came over, and we all did it together. And it was like a mini class, and it was really cute. And we got to test out all the products. And then afterwards you could kind of choose what you wanted to buy from them, like what products you liked and everything. But it was cool because not only did I learn some stuff that I didn't know about like makeup and whatever, but I also got some like really good products. Like I really liked their mascara. It was really good actually.
Oh, that's so interesting. Yeah, I love learning about products because I feel like you can listen on YouTube and stuff like that, but it means a lot more when like somebody's in front of you and like actually showing you.
Yeah, exactly, for sure. So I have one more makeup story to share. And it was kind of a really bad makeup mishap. So there was this one time where I was recording a YouTube video for my channel with one of my best friends, who's also named Kiera, ironically, and a close family friend of mine, like her daughter was with us, and she was 10 at the time. So she was, you know, younger than us, but she wanted to do this challenge for my YouTube channel. So I was like, all right, cool, we'll do it. So it was the blindfolded makeup challenge. So basically, for those of you who don't know what that is, it's where one person's blindfolded and is putting makeup on the other person. And it did not end well. The little girl who's 10, she just like was blindfolded and she was doing Kira's makeup. And she got mad because Kiera kept moving around and she was like, stop moving. And she like jabbed the eyeliner forward and actually like stabbed her eyeball like the eyeliner in her eye. And I actually have it on video. So like, it's just like, it was crazy. I was like, oh my God. Like I actually had to like stop recording because like she literally stabbed her eyeball out of eyeliner. Like I've never seen anything like that before. You know, she washed her face out and she was fine, but it was just like crazy, you know, like,
right.
It was very like dangerous. I kind of should have saw that one coming, to be honest, like doing a blindfolded makeup challenge. You know what I mean? Like that just, I feel like just listening to that, it just doesn't sound like the safest challenge. You know what I mean?
Right. No, I agree.
Like granted, like she had her eye open. She should have had her eyes closed knowing that she was using eyeliner, but like, I don't know, like, and also, like, the little girl should have known to not stab somebody, like, with the eyeliner, you know?
Right, no, 100%.
Just crazy, honestly. So, really quick, I want to read the email we received from one of our listeners, who has a story to share with us about a makeup mishap. So, they said, I remember one time I was taking a nap on the couch. My cousins decided to play a prank on me and they got out their makeup kit of heavy lashes, sparkling eyeshadow, and golden sparkly nail polish. And as soon as I woke up, I had no knowledge of the damage they caused. I carried on my day walking greetings of people. Very often I got odd looks and snickers in between of people laughing. And I couldn't figure it out until I looked at my watch and noticed my nails. I was mortified. And then I looked at my face. I have been looking like this for over half a day, apparently, without knowing.
Oh my. That's terrible.
That's crazy. That's so funny because my mom, she used to do that to her friend when they were younger, and they used to go down to the shore all the time because they lived up in that area, and they used to do that to their friend all the time. Every time he would fall asleep in the back of the car, they'd get their makeup out and do the same thing.
And I feel like that's so typical that like a male wouldn't like notice something like that. Like why would you just look at your fingernails, like, you know, especially being a guy, like they're obviously always plain.
That's so funny. Oh my goodness. So sorry that happened, but it's kind of funny. Seriously.
But it was worth the laughs, I guess, for his friends.
Yeah, I guess so. My goodness. So apparently we only have 5 minutes left, sadly, but I'm going to share one last story. It's another mishap that happened, but it was actually like kind of dangerous if you think about it. So I went to go get my ears pierced at Claire's at the time. And it was going to be my second, piercing, because I already have, you know, I had one at the time, so I was getting a second one. And, you know, when I got there, the lady was the only one working there, and there was like no one in the store. So, you know, it wasn't even like she was like busy or whatever, but you know, I kind of told her ahead of time, I was a little nervous because like, I just don't like needles. Like I'm very like anti-needles for anything for that matter. So I told her I was nervous and she's like, there's nothing to be nervous about. Like you won't even feel it. And I was like, okay. So like, I was like literally like shaking as she's about to do like the first year and I'm like waiting for her to do it. And then she's like, okay, it's done. And I'm like, and I didn't even feel it. And that was like my right ear. And I was like, oh my God, I'm like, this is great. Like I didn't even feel that and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, so excited. Then right. She goes to do my left ear. And, when she went to do the left ear, it was like, I don't even know how to explain it. It was the most painful thing I've ever experienced. I feel like honestly, it was just this sharp, like pain. And I literally like screamed and the lady's like, we have a problem. And I'm just like, my mom's like, what do you mean we have a problem? And she's like, the gun's jammed in her ear. And like, my mom's like, what do you mean? And she's like, yeah, the gun got jammed as I went to hit the button to like put the earring in her ear. And now it's just kind of jammed and like stuck. And my mom's like, well, what are we supposed to do? And the lady's like, I don't know. I'm the only one working. So... And she was like looking through the drawers of like the thing where they have all the earring stuff and whatever while she's like holding the gun to my ear. And my ear was like basically bleeding out. And she's just like, all right, there's only one thing we can do. And my mom's like, well, what's that? And she just ripped the gun like from my ear, like completely just like tore it. Like didn't even tell me. And I was just like, and she just like cleaned it up and she's like, you're good now. Just make sure you pay attention to that ear particularly. Like,
oh my God, that is terrible. I would have been crying.
Oh my God, I was so mortified because I was already afraid of needles, like as was, and like,
that is so weird that it gets jammed, that it had gotten jammed like that.
And you would have thought that because of what happened, they would have given us a gift card or something. They were like, here, have 10% off your next purchase. I'm like, what?
Of course, leave it up to Claire's. I know, I had went there twice. To get my ears piercing. The first one, I think it was my, you're right, it might have been my second hole also. And I think my other one was a little further up and I had to take it out. Like, it was so uncomfortable. I guess they didn't do something right.
Yeah, well, part of the problem with Claire's is it's really cheap to get your ears pierced there for the most part. Right. So you kind of should just know, I feel like you should find somewhere reliable. You know, that even if it's a little bit more pricey, at least, you know, you'll be safe because my ear
got infected. Yeah, because it can get like infected and stuff, you know?
Well, that's exactly what happened to my left ear after she got it jammed and like just ripped the gun from my ear. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I mean, you can't tell looking at my ear now, but like, I mean, it's just, it was crazy like that to think that that even happened. And they just kind of shrugged it off like, well, here's 10% off. Bye. Like,
right. Right. Oh my God. How just, like, crazy. Awesome.
No, honestly, it's just really scary. You have to be careful of earrings, and especially like when you do get them done, there's an entire like set of rules you have to follow within the first like few weeks of having them pierced. And you know, it's just, you got to make sure you follow those rules, otherwise it will get infected. Like, you have to use the solution that they give you at like 3 times a day, I think it is, and yeah. You can't out and etc, you know.
Yeah, definitely. It's dangerous. Like Kiera said, make sure you go to a good, you know, reliable place to have them done.
For sure. But with that said, we will talk to you guys next week since we are out of time, but we hope you guys enjoyed this.
Bye.
Bye. Say it loud for me now. It's the dance break. Time to work it out. For me now, cheetah in the house, won't you dance for me now? Work it out for me now. Cheetah's in the house, won't you shine for me now? Dorinda, Chanel, Galleria, Aqua in the house, won't you sing for me now?